I don't care that much to make that joke.
Perfectly timed. Ready to go?
Yeah, I'm where I am. Are we recording?
Yeah, we're always recording.
All right, cool.
Before we get started, I got a couple of things I want to talk about at the head of the show. First and foremost, I mentioned on some of the podcasts about a secret project. That's right. For those of you that are still like, wait a minute, there's a podcast? Yeah. Check us out, iTunes, do a search for Baltic Effect. The Secret Project will be coming on, out on that very, very soon. Some steps are in play right now for that. For those of you that you're just getting the audio and you're wondering what is he talking about, of course I know it's a podcast. Go to YouTube, do a search for Trentendo. I post them on the Baltic Effect Facebook page. Post them on the Trentendo page. There went the mic. And we, you know, post it everywhere you can. So if you want the video component of it, of this podcast, go check it out on YouTube. Just do a search for Trentendo. I had my own URL, and then they changed their rules about it. They were like, you've got to have, like, you have to, basically, to get your own URL, you have to be PewDiePie now. And I'm not PewDiePie. But,
I agreed to do this because I thought you were PewDiePie.
You thought I was PewDiePie? I thought it was Felix?
Yeah.
From Sweden? Also, too, go check out Helmia.com. Get some cool swag. Get this cool Helmia Sugar Skull shirt. Go pick up other nautical gear. Go pick up the only place to get Trentendo swag and all kinds of cool nautical themed stuff.
It's true.
Helmia.com.
Nice.
I have no idea that Helmia has bought me a car. Welcome to the Preacher Podcast, brought to you by the Baltic Effect. My name is Trent. This is Nate.
Hi.
We are covering episode 106, Sundowner. You better take care if I find you've been creeping around my back stair. If I didn't get that in.
Yeah.
Yeah. Doesn't mean we can't still do it again. Before we get started with talking about my favorite episode so far.
So good.
I know. Do we have any questions to make me look embarrassed?
I'm sure we do.
I promise that I won't annoy you this time with our special guest.
Eh.
But if something comes up, we do need to include her and ask her, because she was really...
I do have one question for you, and that she will know the answer to.
Okay.
Because I asked her as soon as I walked in.
Did you see if it worked?
I asked, because I... Last night...
Okay.
Last night, I went roller skating yesterday, and I was...
He's a bit of a derbysman.
So I took my pads and my... Because they're all full of stank and sweat.
Mm-hmm.
And my
the derby stank.
And I put it out on the deck, right?
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm.
Wake up in the middle of the night.
The derby deck.
I wake up in the middle of the night. What's happening?
Oh, you didn't bring those in?
Mm-mm.
Yeah, it was storming. Bam.
Yeah, they were soaked.
I was like, I knew it was. I was still awake. And I heard it like coming in. And I was like, yeah. And I had the window open. I was enjoying it. And I thought, that's a really hard rain. Yeah, it was coming all in the window.
So I'm going to ask you two questions.
Okay.
I'm going to ask you first, will it rain tonight? And I want you to say, yes, it will rain. No, it won't rain.
Tonight.
Or it might rain.
Yes, and no, or maybe. Or yes,
might,
no, or might.
It might rain.
It might rain.
And if it's...
It might rain on the plains. Unique New York.
If it's, yes, it will rain...
The Human Torch applied for a bank
what
loan.
What percentage of sureness?
So give you the so weather forecast.
Like if, say, if yes, give
so
me
the
a
weather
number
forecast.
Between... Yes, yes, I am. Yes. If yes, give me a number between 90 and 100. If no, give me a number between 0 and 20. If it might rain, give me a number between... Let's do the first part of the question. Hey, Trent, will it rain tonight?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Might.
It might. What is the... What percentage chance is it?
69% chance.
Ooh, you're really close.
Is it 65?
No.
75?
Nope.
Okay.
Well, getting colder.
Getting colder.
Alexa, will it rain tonight?
It might rain in Madison tonight. There's a 70% chance. You can expect about 0.4 inches.
Cool.
Cool.
Is she quieter?
I turned the volume down. Alexa, volume 5. Alexa, will it rain tonight?
It might rain in Madison tonight.
Alexa, volume 8.
It might rain in Madison tonight. There's
Alexa, volume 3.
Chance. You can expect about 0.4 inches.
You were at 5. You went way too high. And then now bring it back to
Alexa,
7.
Volume 5.
You were just at 5.
I was just at 8.
Sorry, you can only set the volume between 0 and 10.
Alexa, volume 5. Alexa, say something.
Something.
Thank you. That's good.
Alexa, volume 6. Alexa, say something.
something.
That's better.
Okay.
Five's a little too quiet. Anyway, so I want to make sure everybody can hear the other competitor. Now that you've set through that BS, do I get it? Do I get the point? Do I get
nope.
half point?
You were off by one percentage.
But I got half the question right.
Yeah, but...
So I get nothing. She gets 1 point for that?
Mm-hmm.
That's some bullshit. Yep.
I don't make the rules.
That's fair. You do. You 100% invented the podcast pod quiz. No one had ever asked a question for points on a podcast until Nate Bjork started podcasting.
That might be true.
I could have said something else. I would have been true. Keep going.
Here's from Nick CR.
Hey, Nick.
If you want to submit questions to the Nate Bjork podcast pod quiz, send it to nate@natebjork.com.
Don't send it to me.
Right. What?
I will shred that shit. Oh.
Mm-hmm. You will. He'll print it out.
And shred it. I will kill part of our... I will print it on styrofoam and burn it.
Yeah.
And wrap it around an aerosol can.
He's from the South. He will do that. And then he'll go, look at that!
I'll go, sure am warm up in Wisconsin now. Grits. It's so cold up here.
And say he'll say grits, the word.
Yeah, yeah, it's always say. It's the only... It means it's Groot. We are Groot, but we are grits.
Yeah. What are the rates like at the Sundowner Motel, according to the sign outside?
You know what? I should have paid attention to the sign. We all know it's a sign. You should probably know it.
The five-man electrical band said,
$69.95 a night.
The rates are affordable.
Nice.
What is noted as free at the Sundowner Motel on the sign out front? And I want to say, these things used to be free at hotels. And not so much anymore.
It's not free anymore. It was free at one time.
Well, one of these things is not free.
All I can think of is like air conditioning and it's not fucking not Wi-Fi. Air conditioning and ice.
Local calls, HBO, ESPN, and cable TV.
Oh.
You can't really get HBO much at any places anymore.
No, because HBO, you know, they're doing their due with HBO Go, so they want to get that on lockdown.
So what I do is, if I want to watch my favorite HBO programs on the TV set instead of on my laptop, I got the Amazon Fire Stick. You can use it to watch all of your content.
They know.
You can look at...
That's the internet.
Oh, okay. Amazon Fire Stick for home, the office...
And more?
And more.
I was going to say, it's like you were telling my mom. That's not my mom.
Yeah.
That's the internet.
I didn't know about the Amazon Fire Stick until recently when someone said, get the Amazon Fire Stick. And I said, blah, blah, blah. I can watch Game of Thrones on the TV?
Yeah. What's like Chromecast? And Roku?
Can you get HBO now on Chromecast and Roku?
Can you not?
I don't know.
So we don't know. Yeah, I think you can on the Wii U, but I mean, that's a whole other, you wouldn't want to buy that. That's... The Amazon Fire Stick is probably way less than something like that. Anyway, let's keep going. I don't want to,
What textbook?
I mean, if we're going to start promoting Amazon, the real thing that's fucking helping us is that damn tripod, which is the best tripod I've ever had. Amazon Basic. Why am I doing this gag?
We shouldn't be doing the ad, but this isn't so much an ad as I really believe in this product.
Yeah.
Amazon is fantastic.
I'm about to order an office chair. I'm going to order Amazon Basics.
I remember when I was in, it was what, 98, 99? A friend of mine had just got a book in the mail. Mm-hmm. He had bought it from the internet. And back then, if you put your credit card on the internet, you were an idiot.
Someone was going to murder you.
But he goes, I trust Amazon. And I said, okay.
The internet was the Craigslist of its day.
Yeah. What textbook?
I mean, people get murdered over it.
Oh, right.
There's all those internet murders, you know?
Yeah.
Okay, what was the question? I'm sorry.
What textbook did poor Eugene, RIPD,
was it history?
Take out of his locker? Yes, he was locker. It was history.
Nice. You don't know much about history book.
Don't know much about his... That's the funniest lyric of that whole stupid song.
It's pretty bad. You should have said don't know much about English book.
No, it's science book was the actual thing, because it goes... Don't know much about history. Mm-hmm. Don't know much biology.
Yeah.
Et cetera, et cetera.
Something about something wrote.
Science book.
About that big French old boat.
Yeah, on the big old boat.
About that float. That's hope.
The hope that floats. Sandra Bullock and Harry Connick Jr.
About that joke. That's nope.
What is Emily's... Oh, God, this podcast is so stupid, but I love it.
Yeah, I know. It's fun.
What?
I have a good time.
I watch this and I'm like, ha ha, those guys.
Yeah, so again, if you're listening, go watch it. It's a lot more fun to watch, in my opinion.
Yeah.
And like, it's hard to sit there and dedicate that much time to this, because if you're listening, you can do other things.
You know what I do when I watch this?
Do other stuff.
I put it on a separate monitor.
Yeah, that's the way a lot of YouTube I watch now, which I feel bad because I love a lot of YouTube, but it ends up being like another monitor while I'm working on stuff.
You know what Brendan does, our roommate does, that's hilarious, is he got that little TV VCR.
Like, he's got two gas monitors going.
The kind of gas station attendants use. Yeah. He'll pop in like a VHS copy of Star Wars and have that going while he's doing stuff.
Yeah, he's got some rad tapes too. He's got some pretty good ones.
I gave him, what did I give him?
You gave him, he had Reefer Madness the other day, which I got that too on tape.
You do have that on tape.
Yeah, the old one.
Anyways.
Yeah.
What is Emily's daughter's fever temperature?
Damn, I did not see that. The first time I saw that, I thought...
And say it in a folksy way.
The first time... I will do that. The first time that... Can I earn like a style point if I do it extra folksy?
If you do it in the folksy way that Emily did it.
Oh, fuck. I thought... The first time they showed that, I thought it was an insulin needle. Because I didn't see it well. I was just sitting... I just saw it and I was like, oh, is she like diabetic or something? Mm. Something going on? And the second time I watched it, I was like, oh, it's thermometer. Got it. Okay. But I wasn't paying attention. Well, let's see. If she's running a fever... 103.5.
Close. 102 degrees far from right.
God, I'm so close.
Far from right.
I know.
Hey, Trent.
I know. Canada.
Far from right.
Ah.
What is Emily's official position in the church?
Missionary. Wait, no, she's a, nice. She's a, deacon? I don't know what she does.
Organist.
I thought she had more of a title.
But like on the programs.
Oh, it says.
Why do they keep calling them programs? They're bulletins. Programs are what you have at an entertainment show.
I've heard them called programs before.
Really?
But it is a bulletin.
Yeah.
But I've been to churches where a program and a bulletin are separate. A bulletin is a thing that customarily comes out and gives you like the haps for the week.
Oh.
Sometimes some churches
like
on
please
both.
Pray for so and so, and so and so's mom has a thing.
Well, more,
and also come out for the pancake breakfast.
That kind of thing.
The men's group. There's always the men's group at every church.
The royal ambassadors.
The men's group is always doing a pancake feed. And it's a feed. Do you do feeds down south? We call it a feed when it's just a bunch of food.
We call it like, no?
Ludafisk feed. Oh, shit. Those are disgusting.
We ain't eating fucking Ludafisk down there.
That's disgusting.
We have seafood down there.
Oh, okay. Yeah. We have fish that's soaked in lye. You know, the stuff that...
makes soap out of.
That Tyler Durden burns his hand with.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
No,
I would tell you that it's good, but that would be an untruth.
Yeah, it would be. So is Limburger cheese. I found out that like any one person that says that it's okay, everybody else is literally right, because I tried it and it's terrible.
Yeah.
It as soon as you start, you haven't had Limburger yet?
No, why would I want a gross thing?
I get you. I get it. I'm on board with you, but a guy used to work at a cheese factory and he brought in all these cheeses to sample.
Kevin.
It was Kevin. And I was like, I gotta try it. I'm adventurous when it comes to food. And as soon as you start eating it, your body is telling you this isn't food. Like if you started eating tree bark or gravel.
Mm-hmm.
You would have a sense of, this isn't food. That's the sense that you get when you... It's like eating a shirt.
Mm-hmm.
Except it tastes bad, too.
Yeah.
Like, it just doesn't... It's not food. I'm done. I'm off my box about Limburger.
Limburger.
Yeah.
Bricktail submitted some questions.
Woo!
What is the only way to live, according to Cassidy?
Oh, it's a not depressing. Down. Negative. Negative. No, he's a. Sorry, what is it when you're negative? When you're a. If you're but you're it's a meh. You're not. He didn't. It's a not pacifist. It's a pessimist. Pessimistic. You're always pessimistic.
To doubt everything all the time.
Oh, okay. Which is pessimistic.
I like how I let you wait. I waited for
I
you
thought it
to
was the word
it.
For it.
Oh, okay.
I was trying to get that word, but he just said you doubt everything all the time.
To doubt everything all the time.
Yeah, that was pessimistic.
Nope, because doubt, that's...
God, you are sympathetic to everybody else in this
question. Alexa gets a point for that, actually.
She don't even know what you said. Don't even know what you said.
Who is a shitty tipper?
Oh, Elizabeth Taylor?
Correct. What's that word?
Oh, ammonia.
Mm-hmm. What verse does Eugene love?
Shit, I don't know.
Matthew 19:26.
Matthew, okay.
With God, all things are possible.
Matthew is kind of a teen book of the Bible.
Next set of questions, final questions, three. I don't know the answer to that statement, which is why I moved
the
along.
Response.
Yeah.
I don't think I do either.
It is the one that's nicest to Jews.
Which book is the most Twilight? Keep going.
Shane. Questions.
Right. Oh, yep. Thanks for thank you, Brick Tells. Thank you, Nick. And thank you, Shane.
What make is Jesse's truck?
Oh, Ford?
Correct.
Uh-huh.
How many angel deaths are there before the credits?
Oh my gosh.
This includes when we see flashes of light.
That's crazy that you were able to discern like an actual number. I'm going to have to go like a Dubsky, like a Twinkie, like 20.
20?
Yeah.
He puts 9.
Really? Wow, I shot way high on that one. Cool that you got all that. That's cool.
Hey, Trent.
Not as many as I thought.
You want a beer?
It's 10 in the morning.
Correct. Good questions, everybody. All right. So, this episode of Preacher had some things.
I kicked its ass this time. No, yeah. I didn't. By getting barely enough to beat Alexa, the unreal person. Anyway, what were you guys about this episode?
Okay. So, in general.
You got no laptop on this part.
Yeah. No notes.
If you don't have one, I don't have one too.
Yeah. Well, I guess we'll just have to remember what happened in the show.
I don't.
What's the show?
I watched I watched Dawn of the Dead instead of the remake one.
So in this one, super cool spawning angels.
Yeah. So now we got an answer to
I'd
said to Nate like after we got done watching, I was pretty happy with the episode for a lot of reasons. Like I liked it. I was happy because I enjoyed it. I was happy because I've been harping for weeks, I'm sorry, about not giving, you know, people answers. You know, they're really asking a lot of everybody. I've said it, other people have said it. And I think they did that in this episode. I think they tied up some things and gave us some answers. And now I can talk about a few things freely, which just feels fantastic for me. But specifically, what I'm saying, tying into what you're saying, yes, the showing them coming back is awesome. Because, I mean, it's cool, it's easy, it's simply explained. He's like, how does it feel? He's like, I don't know, he didn't like nothing. I'm back.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes I'm in the same spot, sometimes I'm in another spot. Whatever. Who gives a shit? We don't need the specifics on that to lead right into one of the coolest fights, especially on the show, but one of the coolest I've seen in a little while.
Yeah.
It's way better than that one that happened on Game of Thrones a few weeks ago.
Wrong.
I wanted like everyone to go, shut up! Yeah. And try and throw a spear at
me. Yeah.
Or a sword. I thought it was a cool fight, and it was funny and cool and fun.
Mm-hmm. It was fun. Like, most of all, it was fun.
Yeah, absolutely. And they've already established that Jesse is a fantastic fighter. He's just a brute. And so it was cool to see him. Now, I said this while the episode was going on, and I thought maybe I missed something. The rewatch, I didn't miss anything. It was never addressed why he didn't just tell old girl, stop.
He did.
Stop!
You know, that's a good point. So he's like,
he could have told her anything.
He did say that when they're driving away. He's like, why don't I just tell her to stop or whatever? They're like, don't use it, blah, blah, she's a seraphim.
But they had just said don't use it, and he did use
it.
Yeah,
which that's the only reason I could think of.
My favorite
line
is... I was
thinking the same thing myself.
When he goes, I could use it on you, and the guy just goes, oh, don't. Yeah. like a child.
Yeah.
Like he gave no reason why to not.
Yeah, just don't.
Don't.
How did they end up dispatching old girl at the end?
That should have been a question. He inarticulated her.
See, does that mean he just took her apart?
Yeah.
Because she can, if she's gonna die if you do that.
Stretch tubes. They have a iron.
But she's still gonna die, right? If you just take her shit off?
No, if you take her like arms and legs off and cauterize the wounds, there are people out there that do not have arms and legs.
That's true.
Like, there's lots of them.
That's true.
They play, some of them.
It'd be rugby. It's gotta be really hard to not kill them, though.
The upside is you kill them. I mean,
if you kill them, you try it again. Yeah.
You're back to square one.
Mm-hmm.
My whole thing was just like, I don't know, I didn't use the voice. I wish I wish there was a reason. I wish they would have said it might not work on here. There mm-hmm. are that could have flown in this universe. I'm not going to say why.
They could have just said, yeah, well,
but then that there. Also, if they did that, it would kind of fly in the face of. It's almost like it's breaking its own rule very early, and you know you like rules in TV shows.
Mm-hmm.
And some of those haven't been introduced yet. We haven't had a need to have them yet, and there might not be any of the rules that are in the comic universe that there are in this. They might just keep it as he just decided not to because he's like, and that girl, the lady playing the Seraphim. If you please don't take this offensive. I feel like it's a choice. I feel like it's the actor's choice, and she's doing a fantastic job. She just has this like walk about her that she's, it's clearly like an angel in a human skin trying to be like a soccer mom.
Hmm. Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, sure. It's kind of just the way she's walking to her vehicle and stuff.
Yeah.
Cracked me up to no end. I thought it was super funny.
I don't know if I noticed that, but I did notice she did the stride purposefully.
Yeah. She's got this real interesting stride to her. Huh. So anyway.
Yeah.
But no. So super cool fight. Cool way of shooting it. Neat idea. Funny, fun, like you said.
Yeah, through like hole in the wall and that kind of stuff. Mm-hmm.
What is going on? We've had the doors open trying to keep things cool. Nature's coming in, so.
Yeah.
But anyway, Cassidy's showing up and Cassidy joining in on the fight and everything. And the whole mm-hmm. follow through after that of them washing clothes and him being like, it's like Pulp Fiction.
Yeah.
I wonder what he was going to say in the bathroom when he goes, it reminds me of me. He goes, shut up, Cassidy.
Yeah, I don't know.
I wonder if he was going to say Pulp Fiction at that point in time. I don't know what part of Pulp Fiction yeah. that would have reminded him of, but anyway. So that's what's going on with Jesse, and now he's faced with, and he told those guys to back off,
mm-hmm.
but we know something happened with Quinn Cannon last week, where he, Quinn Cannon.
I hear them say Cannon.
Jackie Earl Haley. Something going on with him. Where he's murdering people after being told to serve God
mm-hmm.
or to believe in God or whatever. So I'm wondering, is it going to last with the angels? Are they going to be able to approach him again? Are they going to figure out the secret sauce to getting around it? Is it just like a 24-hour bug? Like, what's
mm-hmm.
going on?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if we want to go ahead and move forward with this on with the Jesse thing or save
it. Go ahead, later. Yeah.
But, him going through all of this and then him telling Eugene to go to hell.
Yeah.
That was crazy.
Yeah.
The way that was done in the show was masterful because it was like guttural. Like he did it and it was just like, oh, whoa, dude, mm-hmm. shit.
Yeah.
You better get a lid on that. You know, that's fucking crazy. And it also, like a person, like, okay, a guy can drive to his mother, tell her off, and then rip his own heart out. A guy mm-hmm. can do that. He told a girl to open her eyes. But
She didn't heal.
I feel like if he told her to heal, she could heal if he can tell him to go to hell and he goes to hell.
Yeah, but then how come Cassidy couldn't fly?
I was thinking the exact same thing. So that's a little...
But he did amp it up with severe anger. Like, maybe if he...
There's like an intensity level?
Maybe there's an intensity level. Like, go fuck yourself. And then they go fuck themselves. But he's like, ooh, go to hell. And they're like, whoa!
Daniel Tosh had a joke where he was like, it's just a little quick little one-liner kind of joke. But he's like, how do you think Superman flies faster?
Yeah, I get that he flies, like, but do you think he has different speed? Do you think he like one-arms it with a bitch?
Oh, is that the rest of the joke?
Yeah.
Nice. I just remember him going, because then you start thinking.
Yeah.
He clinches. So that's what's going on with Jesse leading up to him. Trying to pack the church. I'm just wondering, are the seats intended for... I'm assuming that...
There's for overflow.
So the extra people will sit out there, listen on the thing, and look...
Yeah, I got a feeling that you could only probably seat 50, 60 people inside the church.
Uh-huh.
And they were printing out 100 programs. Mm-hmm.
I thought
200, sorry. 200. 200 programs.
200.
So they were looking for the whole town mm-hmm. of Anvil.
Yeah. Yeah, and getting on to that, the whole shit with Emily... that's kind of all there is in this episode. There's just Jesse's shit and Emily's shit,
well,
kinda.
Sort of. I mean, we didn't talk about how Tulip and Emily.
Yeah, Tulip and Emily
had
their
little fun thing, and then like how Cassidy and Tulip, Cassidy's like, oh man, we're a thing now. And
classic love triangle.
Uh huh.
Irish vampire, housewife, preacher with a demon.
Housewife.
Yeah.
Who's a housewife?
Emily?
We're talking about Tulip.
I was gonna say love triangle and connect all four of them.
Oh, okay, got it.
It's Cassidy, like Tulip, a triangle. Tulip and
I forgot how many sides.
The four-sided triangle.
Yeah.
The Tulip and Jesse, Emily and Jesse. Mm-hmm. So at some point to connect this.
And the mayor.
Oh, and there's the mayor. Mm-hmm. Oh wow, Anvil is small.
Mm-hmm.
It's time to move.
Now,
there are other places you can make more money. You can get cheaper housing. There always is. Always is. But it wouldn't be as fun. But yeah, the whole thing of her just storming in and never... Does Emily know that she's... She has to. Because
she said, stay away from my boyfriend.
Right.
She knows that those two have had a history. She's seen them talk when he's trying to... baptize her,
uh-huh.
And she got all like, you know, tulipy with her.
Okay,
with him. Like, I think she knows. She's got.
Do you think she's put it together, or has someone explicitly explained it?
She's put it together.
Okay,
all yeah.
Right. And so, because
they small town.
Well, they were talking about him, what they did together. Like, oh, either that or Tulip was just talking about her past.
She was talking about Jesse, and it was clear to everyone at the the diner. That she was talking about Jesse in the last episode.
Oh, right. Yeah,
so that gets around.
Yeah, true. It was Animal. Gets around.
Plus, what's his face? The kid who was like, my pa hurts my ma, was like, I heard things about what you did from before. And like, so everyone knows this.
He knows from, okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, they know about him, not from her. The stuff from the bad stuff is people know who he is. Remember the sheriff talked about that a little bit. He's like, I was worried that the bad times were coming back or some shit like that. People know he's a bit of a hellraiser.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So, but yeah, the whole thing with her, like Tulip comes in, breaks the craft thing, goes out to the car.
My kid's art thing.
Art thing. And then Emily goes out. You broke my kid's art thing. Storms back in. Tulip comes again. I'll fix the art thing.
Yeah.
It was a funny little back and forth.
Yeah, it was.
I do hate that this whole Jesse, will you come with me thing has, like, evolved to the point where I'm starting to extra be annoyed with Tulip. Her acting very prissy in this episode detracts from me.
Yeah.
I like her. I like her as a stronger character.
What do you mean? How? Explain. What do you mean by acting prissy? I don't understand.
Like, going into another girl's house and saying, stay away from my man and throwing a toy?
Okay.
That's a hissy fit.
Okay.
That's, come on. She's, okay. I feel like she's tougher than that.
Okay.
She is impulsive, and she was acting out. She was acting out. You know, she didn't really put a lot of thought into it, and she didn't want to go in there and, like, kill her with a homemade bazooka. I get that. I get it. But I also kind of feel like, as strong of a character as she is, it would have been nice for her to just, like, not even worry about that. Granted, though, what she did worked, because she wanted to get Jesse's attention again. Then Jesse thanks Emily and says, you and Tulip did a great job. And it just fucking burned her up.
Yeah, it burned up Emily.
Yeah. But yeah. Anyway, I thought it was a fun thing. And she finally tells us what the damn car was. I didn't know they made a Ford or a Chevelle.
Mm-mm. Well, they did in 72.
That's what you said to me when we were watching the episode.
Yeah.
Clearly. <Yeah. laughs> But I was thinking it looked like a Chevelle. I was like,
yeah, they had those kind of tires, too. The
tires. TA? Yeah, mm-hmm. TA tires. Which why are you going to get TA tires and not get the white letters? What are you doing? What are you doing with your life?
It's low profile.
350 crate motor? What, you don't have the 455? You can't rebuild the original? You have to buy a 350 crate?
Low profile.
Flowmaster? What are you, a teenage boy?
She's already getting pulled over for speed, and she doesn't need to go faster. Plus, everyone knows that those white wall tires break down faster. The white area?
Not white wall. White litter.
That's what I meant. Letter tires break down faster.
Yeah, that old adage.
Mm-hmm. Those are tires she found.
she took them off. Yeah, she took the whole car.
Yeah. She didn't buy that car.
She didn't like restore it.
Yeah,
send it to a body shop and mail checks to them for months and get pictures and then finally get it out the day she retires.
Yeah,
like most people, how they get muscle cars nowadays. But yeah, I mean that's kind of what's going on. With that, we got a little small nugget of the mayor faking the deaths of everybody and that really gnarly act. I thought for a second it was Eugene and the other boys.
Hmm.
Or like he said, go to hell. And I thought it was like,
oh,
I thought he like transported to being burned up because the guy had some kind of funky teeth going on.
Yeah, but it was the mayor. As soon as we saw it was the mayor, we knew what it was.
Right, yeah. As soon as we saw him, it's like,
and
oh.
He was, and Preacher Man was like, do stuff. He's like, okay.
Yeah, it's not God, or you're hearing the same thing as God.
Yeah, like, it was kind of an interesting phone call, wasn't it? Or like, sorry, I've been missing my call. You know how, like, sometimes with your phone, like, you 30 messages, you don't get it, and then you get a bunch of... Anyways, your people died?
Yeah, he's like, thought you want to hear it from me. Yeah, well, I got a call from the state highway patrol. I was trying to think of his voice. I forgot what he said. But, yeah, no. So he did that, faked their deaths to get out of that shit. So that's maybe going to come back, maybe not at all. But I'm interested to get back to Jackie Earl Haley and see what's going on there.
Yeah.
The aftermath.
They must
of
have
that.
Like had him take a break for a week. Well, you don't, when you film these, you don't actually film a week at a time, duh.
Well, he, I read before the show started that he signed on for 6 episodes. I don't know how true that is, but I know we've only got him for 6. Oh, well, I think that we only have him for 6 because I just said I don't know how true that is. But, anyway, the only other thing I can think of that's kind of worth noting, which is kind of moot now that he's in, hell, mm-hmm. is the Eugene making friends. I thought that was going to be them setting him up.
Yeah.
I thought they were going to get him to, like, try and sneak in someplace and then get the F out of there while he's stuck holding the bag.
See, I thought that might be the case, but I had the feeling that this little blonde kid was just a nice boy.
And maybe, like, him getting forgiven from that woman. The other kids are like, hey, let's hang out.
Yeah,
yeah. Because they weren't, like, overdoing it.
Yeah.
They were like, can we sit here? Hey, do you want to follow us to this thing? They weren't like super all of a sudden, oh my God, let's talk it out. They were just like, hey, we'll sit near you.
Yeah.
So yeah, it was a little more organic. The fact that he puts his meat smoothie right down on the butthole drawn on the table.
Mm-hmm.
Like what? Why? Like why? You can't move one seat down? Does he not want to see it, do you think?
Probably, possibly.
Like, what's the? I don't know.
I don't know.
I just thought it was an
maybe
interesting.
Maybe that's his spot, and he's not moving.
Maybe he.
I mean, it was written there because it was drawn there because that's his spot, and he's
like, fuck
he probably him. Thinks he deserves it. To be honest.
Well, I'm glad that you said that because it reminded me. You know what? If he's gonna sit here and be unhappy because he's happy, be careful what you wish for.
So he deserves to go to hell.
Not at all.
Okay.
Not at
okay.
all. What he deserves is happiness.
Yeah.
If he can come back from hell, if he can, I don't know. I don't remember if that happened in the comic or not. But if he can come back from hell somehow, then I think at that point it would be fair to say, fucking be happy. Be happy. He deserves happiness is what he deserves.
Yeah, he does.
Doesn't deserve to be in hell at all. But if he's still in hell, fuck you, Jesse.
Mm-hmm.
Still fuck you, Jesse, but a slightly less fuck you, Jesse, if you can get him back out of there.
Yeah, and fast.
Oh,
I'm sure time runs differently.
Sure.
Like Narnia.
Mm-hmm. It is. It's what's what they said. Narnia. That's what happens in Constantine. You hadn't got there yet, but they talk a little bit about. Hey,
I might watch that a little bit after this.
It's a good companion piece to Preacher, in my opinion. Very different things, but just similar notes. But what else you want to talk about in the episode? I mean, I have
a theory, but I don't want to bring it up because then you'll say. You want me to tell you if that's true or not?
I won't. I won't. Okay. I want to hear it. Because I don't all know right. the minutiae. I don't
those
know
those two fellas.
Oh, okay. The angels?
Those two angels.
Uh-huh.
They're not only the guardians. They made it.
Oh, you think they're the demon and the
they're,
angel?
Yeah, well, they're the parents. Know. They're the parents, I think.
That'd be fucking dope, right?
Because we all know that they don't
they're wanted, not supposed to be together. People are coming after them.
And we already know that they're... These are sexless creatures.
Yeah.
And this is the form they took. So who gives a shit?
Yeah, no.
You could probably make babies out of whatever you want.
It's not going to be a traditional, P and the V, S
right.
and the O.
It's got to be like some kind of... we wouldn't even... If we witnessed an angel and demon copulating, we probably wouldn't even recognize what it was.
Yeah, it probably looks like this. Made a baby. Demon angel baby.
Mm-hmm.
Demon angel. That's cool. I hope that is. That would be a really interesting thing.
How was them? And they're like, oh, you left her alone. And oh,
It would make, oh, the classic like husband and wife like bickering kind of thing.
Yeah.
It would also make more sense as to why the angels are coming to kill them too. Although they weren't. Seraphim didn't try and kill them. Seraphim showed up and was trying to get the F out of there. She might have wanted to kill him. But if they are... it does say wanted, like dead or alive or some shit on that poster. Why would you want to kill him? Why not just go get the thing you're trying to get back? Unless they're trying to get it for them. Unless they're not sent by God. Maybe they're trying to get it for their own selves.
Well, people don't know if this is missing either.
Well, yeah, they do. There's a wanted thing.
They don't know why that there's a wanted thing.
Because
they were saying the parents of the baby were saying if people knew that this thing existed,
maybe that's why he didn't use the voice when they were fighting.
Could do. Maybe
because if she gets out of there, what if she heard it and then
she'd
like,
be like, "Holy crap! Did you hear what I was just down there in the stupidly named power?"
I like these, like the band. That was pretty good. It's it is a stupid name when you tag Terminator to the front of it.
Mm-hmm.
Genesis. All right. Well, anything else?
Nothing else.
I'm glad you brought that up.
Yeah, let's hit some emails.
Yeah, man. They get to watch us looking for emails. If you want to send us emails, send them to BalticEffect@gmail.com.
That's correct. BalticEffect@gmail.com.
All right. You want me to let me start up?
Sure, since I'm still logging in.
Okay, let's see. I've got to switch accounts because I'm looking at stuff I shouldn't be looking at. BalticEffect. There we go. Okay. We did 104, 105, 104. Five. We did Nick CR. So all we have is Bricktails and Shane this week?
And Nick CR.
So his is 105.
But look at it.
Sundowner. Okay, cool. Yeah, there is that whole confusion with whatever. Yeah. Cool. Hi, you fellas.
Hi.
Okay, I'm officially loving this show now. That fight scene at the motel was something else. The Angels reinvigorating throughout made it just awesome. The way it was shown through the hole in the wall was cool, and the dialogue was cracking me up. Stabber Gently was the funniest line I've heard on TV since It's a Flying Saucer, Ed. Come on, we've got to go in Fargo.
That was funny. Season 2 of Fargo.
God, so good. So the best line in Season 2 of Fargo, excuse me, is after he beats some serious ass and goes, I'll take a chocolate glaze and old-fashioned. That's my favorite. Love it so much. Okay, and the line that wasn't said that I wish it was, when he gets the phone call after the thing happens in the diner, he's like, I just wanted him to be like, okay, oh heck, calm down. Okay, so you what now? Okay, I'll be there in a minute. Hey, hon, I got to go out to the Waffle Hut. You want a donut? You. Anyway, I just wanted like the non-interesting dialogue said in a Minnesotan accent is my favorite thing.
It's good stuff.
Again, I was grateful for closed captioning, for example. Watch out for the cord. She's going to electrocute you. I did hear that on the second one. Electricity crackles. After that, the whole episode seemed to be a series of conversations developing the characters' relationships with each other while it inched the plot forward, but I'm not complaining because the dialogue is so entertaining. I also like the gimmick of having a different vandalized slogan on the church's sign each week. Seth Rogen says this is an homage to The Simpsons. According to him, they don't want to admit that they stole the idea, so they're calling it an homage. A homage. As usual, the episode was shot beautifully and even included a Breaking Bad-esque time-lapse scene transition. It did. It looked super cool.
What part was that?
So he sets up the chairs, it turns to nighttime, and then the next morning. That's
oh, right. Yeah.
And you can see some huge city. I wonder if that's supposed to be Lubbock or something. There's a big, big city way off in the distance.
Mm-hmm. You can go to the world's oldest dance hall in Lubbock.
Really?
Not world's. Obviously, but in the
world's oldest dance hall is a castle somewhere.
Yeah,
it's a field.
Yeah,
it's that's great. It's funny, but it's the world's oldest. Yeah, I got you. No Quinn Cannon this episode, which was a bit disappointing because I really want to know how he thinks killing those people is in the service of God. Now it's even more complicated as Miles, the mayor, has obviously done something bad covering up the murders, but that he thinks will save a lot more people from being hurt. Well, what are these guys up to? I want to ask that more inquisitive. So Eugene is taking an unexpected trip to hell. This can't be good. No shit. Fjorn de Blanc told Jesse that if angels and demons learned of Giannis's existence, they would highly covet its power. I'm not going to say it that way anymore. I'm sorry.
Cool.
Okay. You glad them?
I don't mind.
Well, if it's in response to Terminator, I feel like you have to.
Okay. Is that how they pronounce it in Terminator Genesis?
No, it's spelled with fucking Y's.
Yeah, that's true.
Stupidly. Like, it's Terminator. Do you need to make it cooler? It's a robot that travels through time. What more do you need to make this cool?
Pronounced Leonard Skinnerd.
Leonard Skinnerd.
Okay.
Well, Eugene's sudden arrival in hell alert demons to this. That's interesting. Also, it's hard to tell if Jesse regrets what he has done just from the brief look we had of his face when he saw Eugene was gone. Can he bring Eugene back if he wants to? I don't see how, as it seems he has to speak with the voice of Genesis to the person he wants to affect. I can't wait to see what happens next. I'm glad that the show that has me anticipating like this. In the meantime, I've got three pairs of khakis laid out that I can't just can't choose between, so I need to go think that over. Cheers, Nick CR.
Thank you, Nick.
Sorry for botching your email. Because they're always good. You want to take Bricktails?
Bricktails, woo! All right. Bricktails, hello, gentlemen, and...
Hi!
Some quick thoughts that have nothing whatsoever to do with Breaking Bad. Wow, that was a pretty damn good episode of Preacher. I've been on the fence so far, but this was great. That action sequence, lasting all the way through the first two acts, was amazing. It reminded me a little of The Matrix, in a way, with the reappearing angels, sort of like Agent Smith zapping into random people's bodies.
The Burly Brawl.
I did like the various interactions between Cassidy and Jesse, Cassidy and Tulip, and Tulip and Emily, but I hope the show doesn't spend too much time on them all moping around after each other.
I agree.
Great shot of the mayor choosing which pair of tan pants to wear. When I was a kid, my dad worked in an office, and his closet had a few dark gray or dark blue suits, a bunch of white shirts, and a rack of variations on red ties.
Nice.
It's a very similar set of choices on what to wear each day.
Hey, it's simple.
So Tulip had a kid once.
Yeah.
What's up with that? Was it Jesse's? Was it adopted? Killed? I'd like to hear more about the backstory there.
Did she launch it out of a cannon?
Shouldn't Tulip and Emily know each other already? It's the sort of town where everyone should know everyone. Or is Emily not from the town originally? Maybe her husband?
Yes. She should, unless she's not from there originally. Fuck. Yeah, okay, keep going. Sorry. Yeah. It just hit me like a ton of bricks.
Maybe her husband was from there.
A ton of brick tails.
Yeah. Maybe her husband was from there, and after he died, she stayed. Do we know for sure she's a widow, or am I just assuming that? No sign of the underground pressure release valves this week. Mm-hmm. There's not a lot of time left, so if that's going to be a major plot point, they'll have to develop it soon. Or maybe it's something that will come up in the last episode as a cliffhanger for season two.
It'll be like the end of big, what's that? Nothing But Trouble. You ever seen that terrible movie?
Uh-uh.
I don't have time to go into it, but yeah, they're in like a big junkyard through most of it, and then like it explodes from all the methane that's coming out. Anyway.
So as a cliffhanger for season two, and by the way on that, Preacher has been renewed for a 13th season 2 next year.
That's what I'm talking about. Keep watching it, peeps.
He does. There's a link saying as such. I will just not. I'll believe it without clicking the link.
Toad's fine.
Yeah,
I believe you.
I haven't. Oh, excuse me. I haven't seen much buzz on the show, so I was worried it would be canceled and leave us hanging.
You know, and I don't...
It was doomed when you put it opposite HBO's Game of Thrones.
It is. It's a hard time slot, summer as it is. Game of Thrones has to be as amazing as it is to keep it going very well through the summer. You know, this is not good months for TV, but Game of Thrones is freaking Game of Thrones, so they can do whatever they want. But yeah, it is ballsy. Maybe that's just like, maybe AMC's like, we'll give you a chance, but you're taking this slot, you know?
Mm-hmm.
We have Walking Dead to get back to. Now let's go count our money. Yeah.
Sunday is good TV prime time, though.
Yeah, especially AMC's been doing.
I gotta get home and watch Sopranos. Goes back to that.
Yeah, that. There you go. Very good point. You know? Yeah, and then Breaking Bad carried the tradition.
Mm-hmm.
I'm so excited that there's a second season. I'm so happy. I was gonna say I don't know a lot about the hype or anything on the show because. If I read an article, mostly I just catch the AV Club, just because the AV Club will be pretty darn honest with their feelings about stuff. They're pretty harsh on a lot of TV shows. Mm-hmm. They don't, you know, just like fluff it or anything. So that's usually the one that I end up catching. And so that's not really hype, you know. It's like a visual podcast, basically. I'm sorry, go ahead.
No, it's okay. I glanced ahead and I saw something funny. Okay. Sorry.
Now you can't not think about
that. I know.
Anything.
Yeah.
Don't you hate it when you're at work and you got to talk with someone professionally and you just I was at work and I saw a picture of a coffee mug that says coffee makes me poop and then I got a call.
Nice.
Had to bury it. Had to bury it down.
Yeah. Let's do the dishes after this.
Yeah.
Because maybe the flies are part of that.
I hope not.
Okay.
Glad we brought that up on the podcast.
Yeah, it's a good thing to bring up on the podcast.
Yeah, keep reading. Our disgusting house.
Yeah.
There is three dudes living in a house, so.
We keep it pretty good.
The fact that it's not on fire right now is astounding.
Yeah. So Eugene must have been listening to you guys last week, confronting Jesse that by violating people's free will, he was sinning. Mm-hmm. The last bit where Preacher told Eugene to go to hell was cool, but a bit of an inconsistency. So far, the voice has forced people to make choices, not magically make their bodies do things. We saw this when Jesse ordered Cassidy to fly. He tried, but since his body can't fly, he just crashed into a chair.
Although he did, there was a little more oomph, but it was still not flying.
I thought he just had good vampire jumps.
Oh, maybe he does have good vampire jumps. Got some vampire ups.
He's got some ups.
Yeah.
Son. So.
Sundowner, you better.
So when Preacher ordered Eugene to go to hell, he shouldn't have disappeared, but instead he should have actively tried to go to hell, maybe by killing himself, or perhaps start digging if he had a view of hell as being literally under the earth, or in a comic turn, got a bus ticket to Hell, Michigan.
There's a Hell, Michigan?
Yes, and that's what made me laugh.
Oh, that's good. Oh, man.
But if we assume that Eugene is now actually in hell, is Preacher going to have to go there to save him? Or send the angels to do it for him? Well, guys, you don't have to go home, but you can't pray here. Brick Tales.
Woo-hoo. Nice.
Thank you, Brick.
Thank you, sir. All right, and I got the last one here from Shin Ogle. Hola!
Hi.
Sorry about last week. I intended to send in one email about both episodes, but time got away from me, and it was too late before I remembered to write them. And to clarify, I actually saw this from the little... My phone will show like a little blurb of the email. I saw this and I was like, oh, don't, it's fine. You don't have to defend yourself. And to clarify, I didn't mean I don't have to send an email this week. I like writing emails is a chore. I just had a lot on my mind that night. He did. He got robbed. It was at gunpoint. So, hey, you get a pass. It was a joke, buddy. Okay. He says, anyway, how about this week's preacher, huh? Bullet point one. I liked how the large Sundowner Motel... Chiron?
You're not going to get help from me. I don't know what that word is.
Alexa.
Oh, the Chiron.
Alexa, what is the word Chiron?
I'm not sure what you meant by that question.
None of us know what this means.
Alexa, what is the word Chiron?
Sorry, I didn't understand the question I heard.
I thought it, maybe if I said it in my voice.
I speak well.
Yeah, I know, but like sometimes different people sound different to me. Oh, so I was watching this podcast on the TV here.
This is the best.
And it's hilarious because she goes, Alexa, say hello. And she goes,
hello.
And she goes, on the video, she went, nothing.
Yeah.
I was watching it on the TV here, and she right there, she goes, hello. So I had to hit the mute button.
Yeah.
Because at one point, they both said them at the same time. I don't know what you mean by that question.
That's awesome that they synced up that way, which makes sense.
There's a slight delay, so it was like a weird echoey thing.
That's interesting. It's so funny. It's so great. Hey, so I liked how the large Sundowner Motel word, I don't know, was on screen over the actual Sundowner Motel sign. So it's whatever the... You know, the superimposing. I think I missed an explanation. Does Genesis not work on Seraphim? Obviously, it works on other angels. I was just wondering why they killed that one over and over rather than have Jesse command her to stop fighting or something. That's where we all are. I like that Tulip and Cassidy finally figured out they both know Jesse. Now he just needs to figure it out so they can become a three-person fighting team. Yeah. Or choose neither. He doesn't have to choose. Something about someone being an island. I thought the main bad idea of the episode was going to be Jesse hooking up that megaphone to use Genesis over it at the church. I was wrong. I thought the same thing. I also thought maybe the megaphone was going to be already on and the crowd outside would hear Jesse yelling at Eugene and that would become a problem. I was wrong. What actually happened? Damn. I wonder if there's a way to undo that. That was fucked up. All right, guys. I'm done for now. Hasta la vista. Shane, the future seeing pod. Did you find it?
Yeah, it's the television graphic.
Okay.
I don't know how to still learn how to
process. And superimposed, yeah.
All right.
Right on. If you want to be like these guys, send your email to BalticPeg@gmail.com. I want to thank everybody for emailing so far. Another reminder, go check us out on YouTube. Go check it out on iTunes. If you're not doing one, if you're doing one, check out the other just for 1 week. See if you like it. Think of anything else?
Check it out on... Come on, check it out. Don't... Okay, if you like it on one, check it out on the other, you say.
Mm-hmm.
I think if you like it on the YouTube, you don't necessarily need to check it out on the podcast.
No, I don't think so. You get the most out of it from YouTube, and you don't have to go in and subscribe and download and then move it to a device, unless your device aren't like an iPhone or something like that. But with that, you just go to the channel.
Mm-hmm.
There it is. And if you have
YouTube, you'll get it if you subscribe.
Mm-hmm.
It'll give you. I get my phone. I get a thing. It says Preacher Podcast, and I'm like, oh, okay.
It's up, yeah. Mm-hmm. That's how I know, because my other email is subscribed to my channel through that profile. So when I started uploading before I go to work, and then I'll get an email going, oh, it's done, cool.
Mm-hmm.
My computer's going to shut down in a little bit.
Yeah.
Nice. But anyway, yeah, check it out. And for everybody that has been checking it out, thank you very much. It looks like the show is giving us what we want. We're getting another season. This is fantastic. We'll do the podcast again next year. I mean, unless something crazy happens with this, like, I don't even want to say, but I do want to say that Nate is nice.
Trent is nice.
Stella's a pretty cutie. And
we love you.
We'll get it like dead on one of these times.
I think we got it.
Alexa, do you love me?
I can't do that, but I can find Lionel Richie songs if you like.
Alexa, do you think I like Lionel Richie?
I can't find the answer to the question I heard.
Alexa, do you think this is a game?
I can't find the answer to the question I heard.
Alexa, what makes you think I won't cut you?
Sorry, I didn't understand the question I heard.